and when his arms, unhappy wretch, he tries to lift unto his mother, arms to lift were none, but stretching forth his mangled trunk of limbs bereft. Look, mother, he exclaims. Loud howled Agave at the sight, his neck fierce grasping, tossed on high his streaming locks, her bloody fingers twisted in his hair, then clamoured loudly, Joy, my comrades, joy, the victory is mine. Not swifter sweep the winds those leaves which early frosts have nipped, and lightly to the boughs attached remain, than scattered flew his limbs by furious hands. The Fourth Book of the Metamorphoses of Ovid. Warned by the dreadful admonition, all of Thebes the new solemnities approve. Bring incense, and to Bacchus's altars bend. Alcathoe only, Minyas's daughter, views his orgies still with unbelieving eyes. Boldly, herself and sisters, partners all in impious guilt, refuse the god to own, the progeny of Jove. The prophet bids each mistress with her maids to join the feast, sacred the day from toil, their breasts to clothe in skins, the fillets from their heads to loose, with ivy wreathe their brows, and in their hands the leafy thyrsus grasp. Threatening he spoke, in words prophetic, how the fronted god would wreak his ire. Matrons and virgins, haste, throw by their baskets, quit the loom, and leave the unfinished threads. Sweet incense they supply, invoking Bacchus by his various names. Bromius, Lyaeus, power in flames produced, produced a second time, god doubly born, born of two mothers, Nicias, they exclaim, long-haired Thyoneus, and the planter famed of genial grapes, Linnaeus, too, they sing, Nyctelius, Elelcus, and aloud, Iarchus, Evan, with the numerous names, O Liber, in the Grecian land thou hold'st, unwaning youth is thine, eternal boy, most beauteous form in heaven, a virgin's face thou seem'st to bear, when seen without thy horns, stoops to thy arms the east, where Ganges bounds the dusky India, deity revered. Thou impious Pentheus sacrificed, and thou the mad Lycurgus punished with his axe. By thee the Tyrrhene traitors in the main were flung. Adorned with painted reins, thou curb'st the lynxes in thy chariot yoked abreast. Thy steps the satyrs and bacchantes tread. And old Silenus, who with wine o'ercharged, with a long staff his tottering steps sustains, or on a crooked ass unsteady sits. Where'er thou enterest, shout the joyous youth, females and males immingled, loud the drums struck by their hands resound, and loudly clash the brazen cymbals, soft the box and flutes' deep and melodious sound.